Hey everybody, it's John. Welcome on back to the shop. I've got a little update that I need to put out if you're building this engine. I've got a couple of emails here recently within the last day or two concerning exactly what plan to order. I know in the frequently asked questions video that I put out about two videos back, I think, I'd said that they're online and that you just order the upright pump engine. Well, when I started this project, I did check the website, and I don't know whether I misread something or it was there and it's no longer there or just exactly what's happened with the folks that are selling the plans, but the specific plans that I'm building look to be no longer available on the website. But don't panic, because there's another engine that's there. It's called the horizontal pump engine. That's virtually identical, except it's horizontal and this one is vertical. So if you have not ordered your plans yet, you can order the horizontal pump engine. And it builds virtually the same, well, almost the same way. Obviously, one's vertical and one's horizontal, but the way you build the materials and everything are the same plan. I've got some pictures I'm fixing to show in just a few seconds here, and we'll explain the difference between the engines that are available on the plans right now. And just as an FYI, occasionally, more than occasionally, pretty frequently, I'll get an email asking for a list of materials and you know, what is this part made out of and what's that part made out of. I'm not putting together a list of materials because there's going to be some things that you might want to change. For example, you may want to use a brass flywheel where the plans call for aluminum flywheel. You may choose to use a cast iron sleeve where the plans call for a steel sleeve and so forth. So the best thing to do is just go ahead and order the plans. Or just use this as a guide for building simple internal combustion engines. But there's not a parts list available from me to build this engine because I'm using a lot of what I have on hand that you may or may not have. So the best thing to do is just follow the plans on that. Well, that's all I'm going to say about that. Here's some slide pictures to help you identify the engine that you'll probably need to be considering if you're following along in this series. Again, I apologize for any confusion that may have happened. It was there, and I'm not selling the plans. It looks like the family that are selling the plans no longer offer that. I do have an email in, by the way, to the Upshur family or the people that are running the website, but I've not had a reply back from them yet. So hopefully I'll do, and when I do, I'll just put it in another video. Anyway, thanks for following along. Sure to appreciate it. Here's a few slides, as I said, that will take a look at the different engines that are available on the website and some things that you may want to consider. When you go to the website, the Upshur Engine website, this is the web page that you'll pull up that has the plans on it. And as you can see, the second engine that's there is one that looks very similar to the one that I'm building. And actually, when I started this engine, I'm pretty sure the plans that I'm following were available. I did order the plans from this website. It was about a year ago. And when I checked back, I just saw that engine sitting there. And assume probably incorrectly that those plans were still available. However, it looks like they're not. I have an email in to the people that are selling the plans right now, but I've not heard anything back from them, but I just sent the email off the other day. The engine that's in the picture that you see right now, although it may look similar, it's actually a very different engine altogether. My recommendation is that if you were going to follow the plans that I'm building, that you do not follow those plans, but actually follow another set, and I'll tell you which ones that those are in just a moment. But first, let's address a few differences in these two engines, if you choose to build it. And I'm sure the engine that they're offering right now is a good, simple engine, but it is not the same engine that I'm building at all. In fact, there's some critical differences in it, and I would also suggest that the difficulty level might be a little bit more. However, with careful workmanship, I'm sure it'll be very successful. One of the differences between the engine that I'm building, and that is the actual engine on the left that I have built, that's an engine that I built before. That engine's about 10 years old, and it runs great. I've got a video of it running, actually. But you'll notice it only has one push rod, while the engine on the right has two push rods. You'll also notice that there's a difference. The engine on the left is what's called a waste oil engine. There is no oil sump or a container for oil like your car engine would have. The engine on the right is totally closed up, And it does actually have an oil reservoir in it. As you can see, the engine that's on the website even has a place to add oil. It has an oil breather and some other things that are on there. So that's a closed crankshaft, non-waste, and it does have two cams, push rods on it, which means that the camshaft inside, even though I can't see it, I know that the camshaft inside is going to be at least twice as much work and is going to require a little bit more precision or a little bit more adjustment to get that engine running. Not that it can't be built by a first-time builder, but it may not be the best for a first-time builder. So, in conclusion, I suppose the engine that's the closest, and I've actually built this engine too, so I know what I'm talking about here between these two engines, the engine that I'm showing in the video series and the engine that I've got highlighted now. I built both, and the engine that's highlighted now is called the horizontal farm engine, and it is identical in every way except for the base. The engine that I'm in the series, the base is mounted vertically, and in this engine, they're horizontal. Now, don't let that water-cooled jacket fool you. The plans will show how to build that both ways. On the Upshur website is the engine that is shown. These are the same engines here from the website. One is vertical and one's horizontal. Those are the ones that you can follow with these plans. So my recommendation, if you cannot find the plans that I have for the upright engine, order the ones for the farm engine that's horizontal. With the exception of that base, which is made the same way, but it's just laid out differently. But it's made the same material, same everything. So that's the one that I would order if I were following this series. Again, sorry for any confusion that it may have caused from that website. As I said, the plans were available when I bought mine, and then someone wrote in the email this week and said, "Hey, I don't think they are," and they are not the same. And again, let me just reiterate, I do not have these plans for sale. I cannot send you a copy of these plans. They are copyrighted, and I would not breach copyright. And I do not have a list of materials. The material list for these engines are going to be really what you have in your scrap box. A good example would be a flywheel. You can make that flywheel out of zinc. You can make it out of iron. You can make it out of steel. You can make it out of aluminum, a bronze. You can make it anything, a brass. You want to make it anything you want to make it out of. The cylinder sleeve can be made out of cast iron. It can be made out of 12L14 steel. It could be made out of a pipe. I've made them out of a water pipe before, just black iron water pipe, bored that out and put that in for a cylinder liner. You can make the thing without a cylinder liner if you choose to and just make it all at one piece. Take a lot of work and time to do that, but you can do it. So I don't have a list of materials that I can send you, and I do not have the plans. So until next time, and I try to put these videos out once a week. I'm just putting this one out right here because I just found this information out. So keep watching weekly. I'll try to release these probably, towards the end of every week until the engine is completed. Thank you for following along. I really do appreciate all the comments that people leave and the suggestions along the way. So until next time when we meet back in the shop, this is John, and we'll catch you on the next video.